In the energy quadrant, taking a look at crude oil, which has a strong up day, helping to start a potential third consecutive up week for crude oil. We broke above 41.33 today, getting to a high of 41.45 and settling at 41.41. That's up 85 basis points on the day. The high was up 95 basis points, and the low of 40.46 had us down almost 1.5%, but we came back pretty strong. So we're now looking at 4 of 7 days higher, but it's been a strongly bullish 7 days, even though that sounds somewhat balanced. Of the 3 down days, Thursday finished near unchanged. That was one of those 3 down days after making a 3-day low. And except for that same Thursday, all of the high volume days have been up days, okay, except for that Thursday, which again, finished near the high. So even though it was negative on the day, it was still a pretty bullish candle. And again, we're now above the sort of secondary channel. The breakout today, the close we had today, was a breakout above 41.43, which now targets 43.43, which is the upper end of that secondary channel that we've been in for about 4 months. So pretty much bullish price action in the short term for that December crude oil contract. OPEC is still demanding compliance. So even though they're scheduled to start pulling back on their production cuts in the short term, they're still demanding compliance from their members. Monday's Joint Ministerial Monitoring Committee, which is JMMC, OPEC members said it was closely following market trends and would not hesitate to call for further supply restraint if needed. And even though, again, we're coming into the time of year when they said they would be pulling back on those production cuts and starting to produce more, at least now, they still seem ready, willing, and able to keep that sort of balance in the market. We're 6 weeks away from the full OPEC Plus meeting of the 23 nations that are in that sort of tacit group of OPEC Plus. But then demand is still the key factor. How demand will develop is a wild card that no one can really predict. The IEA prediction is different than the EIA's prediction. That's different than OPEC's prediction and slightly different than OPEC Plus annual prediction for next year. But all in all, the post-pandemic demand picture is still what's going to drive crude oil markets and probably what's going to drive OPEC's decision as to whether to actually wind down the production cuts or extend them even more in the meeting they've got coming up 6 weeks from now.